I think we have a picture live at a briefing at the Defense Department from, of course, Secretary Chuck Hagel. He is announcing at this moment that reports of military sexual assault are up by 8% over last year. That's according to the Associated Press in their preview of this event. Perhaps an encouraging sign, in fact, that survivors are growing more confident in coming forward. Joining me now is Congresswoman Jackie Speier of California. She's a member of the House Armed Services Committee and a vocal critic of sexual assault in the military. Thank you so much, Congresswoman Speier. It's a real pleasure to have you back on.
Thank you for the invitation. Thank you.
Well, so let's delve into the specifics of this in a moment. But first, your general reaction to the Pentagon coming forward with these new numbers.
Well, here's the good news and the bad news. The good news is we have confirmed that, in fact, the numbers of men and women in the military being sexually assaulted is astronomical. It's about 20,000 based on this third-party study by the RAND Corporation. Mm. The number of confirmed complaints now is down, but the number of unrestricted reports is up. So you could argue, in fact, that people still are afraid to come forward. Probably the most disturbing figure is the fact that 62% of those who were queried said that they were subject to retaliation. So we have a problem is not being fixed. No matter how much attention you say that we have been putting on this issue, and the military has certainly said that, the numbers don't lie. The issue is still a real one. The amount of convictions actually are down, which to me suggests that we aren't taking these cases seriously enough. If you actually file a complaint, you should have that complaint taken through the entire process and to a court martial. What we find is that very few of these cases, less than 10%, actually turn into convictions.
Congresswoman, take a listen to what Senator Gillibrand said on this just a couple of minutes ago.
The DOD needs to recognize that they've promised zero tolerance for sexual assault for 25 years, and today's report proves that what we have today is not zero tolerance, we have zero accountability. If any senator or congress member, if their daughter was in the military, if they had to accept this lack of justice for their son or daughter, they would never accept it. We should not be asking this of the men and women who serve in our military.
She, of course, is among a group of senators calling for another vote on the military's handling of sexual assault. But that hasn't succeeded so far. Her own legislation on this has failed in the past. What's it going to take for Congress to act on comprehensive reform?
Well, the National Defense Authorization Act is on the House floor right now. Our amendment to have these cases taken out of the chain of command was not made in order by the Republican Rules Committee. We're not going to stop. We will continue this fight. We will take it up again next year. There is a growing number of Republicans joining with Democrats who realize that you cannot have persons that aren't trained as lawyers making decisions as to whether or not to move forward with a court-martial or not.
Well, as you astutely narrated here, the big takeaways, reports up 8%, and perhaps most disturbing, 62% of women reporting retaliation for coming forward with their story in the military of sexual assault. Maybe that will finally spur political action on this. Congresswoman Jackie Speier of California, really appreciate your helping us understand.
Thank you for the invitation.